In this video, I will show you how you can use a digital classroom of Math CityMap to organize and track a math trail. So first of all, we start with a math trail that you have selected or you have created, and you need to create the digital classroom first. To create the digital classroom, go inside the gray toolbar and you find the digital classroom as the third button. If you hover it, you will also see the tooltip as Digital Classroom. If you click on it, you will see that for this trail you have, or I have, zero Digital Classroom ongoing, upcoming or completed. So I can just click on New and create a new Digital Classroom. I will give it the name. It will be the Demonstration Classroom, and the second setting is the start date and time. By default it goes to today and the hour that we, so it's the same as here, it's the current time. If you want to schedule it to another date, just click on the icon here and you can select the date and the start time. For today I think it's okay, I will just go for 17 o'clock today, and the duration can be up to 48 hours, so you can just use this slider. So the first one is for hours, and usually you don't need a digital classroom that is that takes so long, so it's by default it's to 1.5 hours. If you want also the minutes, you can go for the second, for the red slider, and change the duration. Here you have in the blue box you find a summary of the duration of the period of time, and you have the start and the end. Now we can configure the digital classroom with some messages. The first message will be displayed when a user joins the digital classroom, and the second one when he leaves the digital classroom or when the classroom is finished. So just for demonstration purposes, I enter here hello, and the goodbye message will be ciao. Now we have the possibility to set some settings. So first of all, if you want to know what the settings do, you can just click the blue icon button, info icon, and you can read what the setting exactly does. In this case I will create a digital classroom with the leaderboard active, and I will automatically assign tasks to the users. This has the advantage that a user sees only one task that has been assigned to him automatically, and this way when you have multiple users using the same math trail, they will be distributed to all of the tasks that are contained inside the math trail. You have three options to assign the task. The first one is progressive, so the tasks are just assigned like first, second, third. Then you have the possibility to assign tasks with uneven first, so you have first, third, fifth. This means that every second task is empty, you have some space between the groups. And the first, the third option is user-defined option. That means you can see all the tasks that are available here, and you can change them via drag and drop to the order, or you can even exclude some tasks. I will go for that one. So I would like the first task to be the mailbox one. Okay, if you're done here, just quickly check it and press the create button. Now we can see although it is not already 17 o'clock, the demonstration classroom session is already showed as ongoing. That is because half an hour before the digital classroom starts, it's already possible for all the users to join it. Okay, I will just enter this digital classroom and we will show or we will see how it looks like when someone enters it. So, in the gray toolbar you see the name and you see that it is in preparation. That means it is not possible for the users to solve any task, but they can already enter. And in 3 minutes it will be live. Right now we don't have any participants, I think it's clear, it's just created. But here you have information on how users can join your digital classroom. And in the setting, in the second tab, it is called the settings. We can have different actions. We have also different options for the classroom, and we will see all the information that we entered when we have created the classroom. There are some new things for the digital classroom with the new web portal. For example, we can now extend the digital classroom for up to 30 minutes, and every user will receive this change also, and you can do it also multiple times. So this means for us it's better to plan it a little bit shortly, more short, and then extend it, because right now it's not possible to stop it in before the time runs out. And the second change, so the second change is that we can receive now push messages. This means when a user enters the digital classroom or he sends you a message, then you will receive a push notification through your browser. The option to send a message to all participants was already available in the earlier versions, but right now it has a it can be reached via this button and via this action bar. So here you can just type any message what you like to send. And the third tab, the events tab, it will hold all the events that were produced by the users. So let's quickly switch into the app, and we will see how it works from the app side. I have prepared here something. Okay, now I can click on the Add Trails button, and here I have to enter a code of a trail or a code of the session. And the code of the session, ah, now I have to minimize it, I can find it here, it's S. So I have to enter it here. I have to write it down for me, sorry. S101021. Okay. I switch here into this tab and maximize it again. So it was S101 and 021. I click on Add. Now I have to confirm some terms and conditions. I will be, the team name will be, well, my name is Ivan, so I call my team also Ivan, doesn't matter. Now click on Enter, and you can see that this is the trail where the digital classroom is running on. And first I need to hit the left button to download it. And now I can start the trail. As you can see, we had the setting to assign the task, and the first task to be assigned was the mailbox. And it worked because I can see only the mailbox and nothing else. And I can also not switch to the other task. So on the top we can see that the session ends in 98 minutes, so it was it's now a little bit longer. And one of the new features with the new version of the MCM app is that we can send audio files and image files. So let's go to the chat. And now I will just this picture here and press the send button. It's the nice city of Fulda. It's really good. If you would like to record something, then you just hit the record button. Hello, hello, test 1, 2, 3. And send it. Okay, so this is how a user joins it, and as you saw, you can now send images and audio files. Also, when I enter the mailbox, and the answer here was 16. Okay, next task. Then it turns green here, this is really nice. And I will switch back to the web portal. So right now you can see there's a new participant, that is Ivan, that is me, and he sent me two messages that I received but didn't read. So if I click on this card here, it opens the chat view and now I can see the picture that was sent and also the audio file.
Hello, hello, test 1, 2, 3.
So you can see it works quite fine. If you want the user to remove, so to kick the user from the session, you can click here on this little cross, delete member. No, but I don't want to kick myself. If you change to the events tab, then you can see all the events that have been sent through the app and with a little timestamp also. Of course, at the moment when I recorded this video, I was not in the city center of Frankfurt, but so I cannot see my own position. Yes, and that's basically... one more thing I wanted to show is one other information, which is now displayed here, is that I have solved one task inside the MCM app, and it was sent also to the digital classroom, so you can quite easily track the progress of all of your users. So if I hover it, I see it's the mailbox task. Very nice. So I hope you could get a feeling of how the digital classroom works, and we'll try to implement it yourself. We are looking forward to hear some experiences of you. Goodbye.